Colorado a little over 2 years. I do swimming at a local rec center near my house in Wheat Ridge, but I do all of my conditioning here at Red Rocks. I do the trails in the summertime when when it's not so muddy and cold, but I have several trails that I do. I walk run steps over there. I do this whole area. But I focus here. This is the winter program. And the summer program will encompass all of those, the other steps and hills and hiking trails and all that kind of crap. One, it is an excellent facility for free. The second is I can do some things. I've had both my knees replaced and my shoulder. And when I started coming up here to Red Rocks, all I could do was walk the steps, and I couldn't walk very far. And my goal was to be able to get back to a point to where I could run. I just want to get myself back to where I feel good about myself.
I've lived here for 9 years.
Almost 5 years.
This is actually the first time I've been here to work out. I've seen several concerts here. I've seen James Taylor and Devontae.
I've only seen Zephyr up there, but I actually do movie nights up here, which are fantastic. Those are lots of fun.
Oh, the Film on the Rocks.
Film
on the Rocks is amazing.
It's great.
But it's a great cross-training venue. So we're here with Team Challenge. It's a half marathon training program for the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation. So we're here to cross-train with the team. Our team is about 60 people. Yeah, our training program with the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation trains all throughout the Denver metro area. So Boulder, Denver.
We try to find like a mix of concrete running areas, trail running, all of that kind of stuff. I prefer anywhere where I don't have to go in a circle.
If you need to drag out of bed, it's nice to come do that with friends.
Especially when it's 30 something degrees outside and cold. It's nice to have somebody to talk to.
I do. I know several people who do the workouts, the boot camps that are here.
Yeah, they have a ton of boot camps. They have yoga classes and things like that. Some of my friends have actually tried to get me to come to. And now knowing everything that's up here, I might actually do that.
Absolutely. I would love to train here more, do some more workouts here.
Oh, this is actually my first day. I decided to come in with my buddies from work. They're all training for Tough Mudder, and I signed up for it. So here I am. I got 70 days to get my ass in shape. I hate working out. I used to be an athlete in high school, did it all back then, and then I hit 21, and it goes downhill from there. So enjoy your metabolism while you have it. It's easy. It's accessible. You have a lot of different options that you can do between the bleachers and the stairs and all the hiking trails and stuff. I used to in the past film on the rocks. Been here for a couple concerts. Willie Nelson was the last one I saw. So that was a lot of fun. That was probably the best one I've seen. I love Red Rocks because I can work out for free.
I greet people that come in and answer any questions that I can regarding something that they might be interested in. When I worked in the gift shop here for a while, at that time they have a tour on Saturday mornings mm-hmm. of the amphitheater, and I used to do their tour for them. And that was when I did the 191 steps, because the tour takes the people to the backstage area, The backstage is built in a series of ramps, and it's built right against the rocks, so that if it's raining outside, the rainwater will drip down the rocks in the dressing rooms and the dining room that's downstairs there. The sound in the amphitheater is just out of this world. It really is. I mean, I've used the amphitheater sometimes. I have exercised and I have walked the steps. Okay? But it's amazing the sound that you get. I mean, even a boom box on the stage, you can hear at the top plaza if they turn the sound up loud enough. Well, of course, we have a big bird population and have a group of birders, they're called birders, that come out and picture and look for them. I guess the ones, I'm not a birder, but the only thing I recognize are the magpies. But I have seen a lot of times deer. But I know at one point, it's got to be 3 or 4 years ago now, they had a lion and its cub, or what, mountain lion and two cubs in the stage area at the top. That was in the wintertime, so I don't know that it caused a problem for anyone, and I would assume, I have no idea what the outcome was of it. I just knew that they were there.
I do security, day security for Red Rocks Amphitheater. 6th or 7th year I've done this, and I'm always down here front of house. I put up yellow caution tape every morning to keep the runners, the crazy exercisers, on the other side. And I get all the lines, make sure that the people are in the lines in the right spot. So, you know, this is general admission, this particular slightly stupid Cypress Hill concert. And there's another band, I can't remember. Make sure that they're seated in the right, or getting in the right spot for the line. Okay. So hi, it's me again, the security guard. And this handsome fella next to me is not your average everyday exerciser at Red Rocks. He does that by day, and what do you do by night?
I'm the drummer for Slightly Stupid.
I thought I'd just throw that out there for you. So give her an A, teacher.
Well, we've been here maybe like 6 years in a row. So we've done quite a few shows here, so tonight should be pretty special. We got Cypress Hill and our friends at Tribal Seeds, also from San Diego. My favorite part about playing here is just everyone who's someone's already played here, so all of our legends, you know, all of our favorite musicians have been here, and so to follow in their footsteps is pretty huge for us.